I mean, but what is important for us, I think, is two things. First of all, we should always keep in mind that 1,000 or 2,000 Swiss francs is still a lot of money. Sometimes when you walk around here in Basel, you get easily the impression that 1,000 or 2,000 Swiss francs is nothing, because you see too many brands that are selling products for 10, 20, 50, 100,000 Swiss francs. But if a consumer has to put 1,000 or 2,000 Swiss francs on the table, it's still a lot of money. Yeah? So this is the first thing. Then I think another important thing is what happened so much in the past 5 years, since the watch market was really booming in the past 5 years, was that many brands have increased their prices far too much. Because you can't just not tell a consumer that you become now luxury, but the only thing that you have changed was the price. You can increase the price and ask for a higher price if the substance and the value of the product also changes. If you have a new movement, new materials, you can ask for a higher price. But if you don't change anything, you just double or triple the prices, and then you explain everybody that you are luxury. As soon as the economic situation is getting in a more difficult environment, those brands are in huge troubles and big pressure. And that's maybe also an advantage of the Swatch Group, because we have in this sense a lot more discipline, because for Hamilton there's no reason to go down because there's Tissot, and there's no reason to go up because we have Longines. And so we keep really we respect our price positioning. All we try now is that in the price segment where we are positioned, like for Hamilton, for 500 to 2,000 Swiss francs, that we really try to bring the brand there to perfection, that we really offer the best possible value that you can get for it. And so we really try also, even in this price range, to pay attention to a lot of very small details. Our quartz movements are only metallic movements. We never use any plastic non-repairable movements. The lining that we use inside our leather straps, they are the same quality of lining that Omega uses. When we use rubber, we only use rubber from Switzerland, where we know it's the top of the top quality that you can get for anti-allergic reasons. When you look at the small details, for example, you have got the holder here on the strap, you have got the screwed back cases, we have a very fine mixture of polished and brushed finishing on the case. So we pay a lot of detail to the watch, but still offering it what we call very democratic price, because it's still a lot of money.